just tried to call you.
Oh. Why were you calling me?
Well, I wanted to let you know how, things turned out after you left. I'm sorry things got so tense. You know, it's the last thing you need right now.
Hey, you needed to know that you weren't really a suspect.
Well, apparently you're the only one who thought so. But you'll be relieved to know that Mac talked me into playing drug kingpin for a few more days to lure Dorman out of his rat hole.
Good. You know, every time I think I know you, you turn around and surprise me.
Yeah, listen, I got pretty angry and...
Hey, you know what? I didn't come here to talk about Dorman or any of that stuff. Miranda sent this to me. And in it, she's apologizing for telling you about what happened in the caves with me and Sonny.
Well, lucky for Miranda, she's out of my reach at the moment.
Jax, I don't want you to try and make light of this anymore. And I don't want you to try and pretend like you don't have a right to your feelings about this, because you do, and I'm glad that it is finally out in the open. I know that I've done something to hurt you really bad, and I don't want to ignore it anymore.
What makes you so sure getting into it won't hurt me even more?
Believe me, I've thought about that a lot. And maybe I'm being selfish. Maybe I'm wanting to talk about it to justify what I did. Maybe both of those things are true. But the fact is, I know you know what happened. But I don't think you understand why it happened. And I get the feeling that you're trying to spare my feelings because I'm in recovery.
Is there something wrong with that?
Yes. It's not my turn to be spared anymore. That's what got me into trouble.
Okay. What is it you want to say?
You're so smart and intuitive. I know you've figured a lot of this out already. But there's some things you couldn't know.
I'm sure.
One of them is how long it took me before I really completely believed that I was going to die. You know, you hear about people who find out they're going to die and they have all this time to put their affairs in order and they get to go tell people goodbye or write wills, make their peace. And then you hear about people who lose their lives suddenly and they don't have time to do any of that. And I felt like that. I was sitting in that cave and I thought I was going to die, and I realized that I had so many regrets. And that I wasn't going to have a chance to say one word of love or apology or thanks to anyone. Jack Sonny was the only bit of life I had left to hold on to in that moment. I would have gone crazy if I would have been down there alone. And he would have too. We had all this hope in the beginning, and we kept on reassuring each other that we were going to be okay and that we were going to be saved. And then we started to get weak. And I got more and more sick. And suddenly there was no air left anymore. And we just knew. We really knew that that was it. And we gave up. Maybe I should say we gave in. Because I think we both really knew in that moment how much we really wanted to live, and we really knew we weren't going to anymore. And every dream and hope that I had of you coming to save me and pull me out of there was gone. I really believed my life was over. And then all of a sudden it wasn't. And the reality wasn't as simple as you pulling me out of the dark into the light. Because of what had happened in those few moments when we thought there was no hope left anymore. I wanted to tell you right away. Everything. But then I'd look into your eyes. My heart would just melt. And I just couldn't. Then I'd try and get up my strength. And I would try harder to tell you.
But I wouldn't let you speak.
I hope you're not sorry you did now.
Here we go again. Scorpio.
Mac, it's Sonny.
What happened with Jax?
Well, he decided to cooperate for a while.
Oh, really? What turned him around? Never mind, I can guess.
Are you sorry that I asked you to listen?
Nope.
I want you to know how important it is to me that you understand.
I do. Look, I've never been trapped in a cave waiting to die, but I know a thing about love and death and the powerful chemistry between them.
I know you do, but what I'm trying to tell you, Jax, is that what happened never would have happened if I hadn't...
If you hadn't been in a desperate situation...
And I'm not trying to make excuses because there are none.
Look, I told you all along I wanted you to be happy. I meant it.
Do you know the last thing I ever wanted to do was break faith with you?
Yes. Absolutely.
I took the easy way out. I should have told you.
It wouldn't have mattered. Sure, you could have told me you made love with Sonny. But what you couldn't say and can't say now is that you love him. I'm sorry. But someone had to say it out loud. I mean, it's no sin that you love the man you loved before you knew me. It's kind of poetic justice. I mean, if it wasn't for him, we never would have gotten together in the first place. I mean, the deal was that you were on my arm to make Lois look twice and make Sonny jealous. What I didn't factor in was falling in love with you. But I did. So I gave it my best shot and I lost. Amazingly enough, it even happens to me. But there's something I want you to know, Brenda. I don't regret a minute that was us. What we had, we'll have forever.
I really did love you. I still do. That's why this is so hard.
Remember all those times I tried to impress upon you how incredibly smart I am? Well, I'm about to prove it by wishing you the best life has to offer and walking away.
I know that's what we need to do. Sorry about nobody leaves.
Well, nobody did. We just let go.